When you hold any material in your hand, have you ever wondered how it looked like under a very powerful microscope? Or when you wash your hand, have you wondered how detergent clean the dirt? Or if you drink milk or eat food, have you wondered how it gets digested in your stomach? If you answer yes to any of this question, then you are at the right place. Hi, I am Jitendra Mata. I am an instrument scientist here at Australian Center for Neutron Scattering at ANSTO. I study nano and microstructure of material using this amazing instrument called QoCa, a small angle neutron scattering SANS instrument. It is like a very powerful microscope, which, unlike using light, it uses neutron as a radiation. Neutrons are produced in a nuclear reactor just there. They are transported to this instrument via guides. Guides are like a highway for neutrons. So you would ask why we use neutron. To understand that, we need to understand how small atom, nucleus, or neutrons are. So if you take up one human hair, and if you divide it into the 1 million times, that becomes a one atom, which is smaller than 1 nanometer. Inside that atom, you have a nucleus, which is 100,000 times smaller than atom. And that nucleus is made of neutrons and protons. So if you want to understand the structure of any material at nanoscale level, then you need to use neutrons as their length scale aligned with the structure you want to study. Neutrons are very useful to study a very large number of systems or science. They have a unique property such as they have no charge, they have a very high penetration, they are non-destructive in their nature, and they interact very differently with different isotopes. So let me explain these aspects to you. Let's say if you want to study a system, artificial muscles, in a very complex sample environment, then you would use neutron because light or X-ray would not penetrate through the sample environment, whereas neutron could easily penetrate through. And you can study this system in its natural environment. So there the neutron have a benefit. So let's talk about QoCa. QoCa is the longest instrument in the guide hole. It's a 40 meter long instrument. It starts from the velocity selector up to the sample position, and then from sample position to detector. Detector moves in this big tank. It can be as close as to 1.3 meter, or it can move up to 20 meter. So that makes it 40 meter long instrument. Now, QoCa uses neutrons from the reactor. It's a monochromatic instrument. So we select one wavelength of neutron. And how do we do it? We use this system called velocity selector. It's a fast rotating turbine. When neutron goes through this turbine, it blocks any slow moving neutron or any fast moving neutron and only allow one speed of neutron to pass through. This neutron then travels through this guide system. Then it goes to your sample. Sample scatters neutron, and you collect this scattering on a 1 meter by 1 meter detector. QoCa detector is the only detector in the world which can take lot of neutrons. It's the state of the art detector. And as I explained before, it moves from 1.3 meter all the way to 20 meter. This gives you a very big size range from 1 nanometer all the way to 700 nanometer. QoCa has a large number of different sample environment. You can study liquid, solid, powders, or even metal sample with QoCa. I'll show you some of the sample, how they look like. So this is called HELMA cell. If you're working with liquid sample, you would put your liquid here, and then that sample loads into our very nice temperature control multi-sample changer. If you're working with powders, then you can use this kind of holder, which can take powder or even small metal pieces. I'm lucky to be involved with so many exciting science since my PhD. Recently, I remember this one project where I'm involved is to study the hydrogel made from the silk and other protein. You would ask what these hydrogels are. This is we use for the biomedical application, specifically tissue repair. As you know, silk is the strongest material nature made. However, it's not flexible. So what we did, we took silk, we took another protein from the insect, which is called resilin. It's a very flexible protein and has a very high tolerance for the fatigue. We combined these two proteins and made a hydrogel out of it. It has a benefit of both. It's very strong and it's very elastic. By doing that, we created material which could be used in tissue engineering or as artificial muscles. Now, we made the material. We want to study the nanostructure. And that's why we have used Quokka and other instruments here to study their detailed structure. Another example I want to give you is this really nice system from Japan. We were interested to study how two charge, heavy charge particle interacts with each other. It's like two notorious kids on the street. If you want to study how they interact with each other, you want to let them play. However, on Earth, you have a gravity, same as they have a parents. So what we did, we took this system of two charge particle, we sent them to International Space Station. And while we are talking about this, actually they are making sample there and understanding how they are interact. Once they will make sample, they will send it back. We will use Quokka to study what they have done. One more project I want to share with you. This is our study about the nanoplastic. So as you know, there is a lot of plastic in ocean. We studied what happens when this plastic breaks down in nanoscale level and how it interacts with the protein. We want to study the impact of this interaction on all the marine mammals as well as on humans.